What's up? What's up? What's up? Today's the 313th day making software. Today I'm going to be working on level 2's art. Yesterday I was finishing up some of level 1's art that had never got done. And today I'm going to be fixing up level 2's art that's just never really got done. This is all kind of hodgepodgey. These light pillars. What's up, Hardboiled? Pedro, yo, what's up, guys? The two newest Steam mods. How's it going, guys? Arcane, what's up? Denied. What's up, Lime Studios? Yo! Thanks for offering to send me a Steam key to your game. I'm so stoked to play it. So I'm working on art today. Yeah, you're the very first one here, Hardboiled. Bam! Super fast, and you're halfway across the world. That's dedication right there. Total dedication. So, yeah, what I'm working on today is artwork. There's a lot that's just never got done for level 2. So, this little landing strip or whatever here, it needs to be like either round on the bottom or something. These light pillars shouldn't be so dark. The light that's coming off of them should be brighter. These statues do not work at all with this color scheme. These lights right here do not fit. So all this stuff I'm working on today. How you guys doing, by the way? I think I'm gonna start with the pillars, the statues. Everything sucks, what? Oh, what's that? What's up, Zanker? Sound Dongs? Howdy, howdy, what's up, y'all? All the art must go. Oh, you mean on here? Yeah, it all sucks. No, it's all just kind of half-assed. It's like all just a hodgepodge conglomeration of random stuff from level 1. I never even got to make level 2-y. Level 2-ish. Okay, let's save one statue as two statue. Scrap it all. We need to start over, boys. All the way from the beginning. Replace all level art with procedurally generated textures via cellular automata. That was the original plan for Songbringer, but I think I'm gonna probably save that for Songbringer 2 or 3. You know, like that's it's more work, really, is what it all boils down to. It also makes this artistic process of drawing things in Photoshop. It turns an artistic process into more of a technical process of coding, which switches your brain. And I don't know, it feels like I'm not as creative when I'm not drawing things as well. I don't know. But I think maybe next game I'll do that. I've done that before. Procedurally generated textures are not that hard. You know, you can just like start off with some gray, you know, so, and then put on some random texturing and then put on some of these runes and other shapes and stuff. You can do all that with code. But it gets very tedious to do, so. But dude, just finished Dark Souls 1 without taking a single hit? Whoa. Wow. You got Skyrim? All right. Cool. Oh, you're kidding? Oh, I thought you were serious. Sorry, I always take things seriously. Yeah, that is the fun part about it, is those accidents. Man, there's a couple dudes out there that are making totally procedurally generated games like that, where their art is all procedural. One of them, shoot, I forget both. Oh, I think there's Desolus, and there's another one. What's the? Oh, his name almost came to me. But anyways, they look really good. And that what's great about them making those kind of games is they do have those pleasant accidents all the time. He later went for a swim without getting wet. Big Mac Dev, when will I be coding? Maybe tomorrow? Maybe the next day? Strawberry Cubes? Let's see what this game, Strawberry Cubes. On Itch, it's probably it. Sweet. Oh, I see you're saying about cellular automata. It's like the game of life, sort of. I like this. Whoa. Sweet, that was a sweet transition effect. This is a really unique game. I like it. It's only a dollar? That's pretty cool. Right. Game of life. Azenris, what's up, man? All right. Back to this. Make this two statue. Replace it. I actually should have a timeline because I think there's. Oh, nope. Oh, yeah, there's only one of these. Okay. So, and then I can delete the other two statues. This is gonna be. Zero two statue. Oh, wait, this is to be 0-2 statue. Oh. Nah, either way. Okay, so two statue I want to delete. Two statue one, two statue two. And I just want to export this single statue frame as two statue. And then see how that looks. What? Did not touch that. You open, reload, reload, hammer spoon. You're too tight. Now they're all gone. Complaining they're not even there. What happened? I should have exported a new two statue and it didn't. Oh, that's why it was gone. That's what's been wrong this whole time. Oh, it's because I think I did the render. There's only a single frame. Single frames don't render correctly. In Photoshop, two statue, zero. There we go. Okay, so that's what they would look like. I do want them to be a little darker. I like this dark look, but not quite this dark for these pillars. Let's see what these look like. Like totally dark. Wiz has taught me patience. Yes. Did I really? Someone was really eager about you checking his message through Kickstarter. I already did that. Who? What are you talking about? Someone is. This on the forums? On Steam? I checked all my emails last night, responded to everybody. Who is this? Where did you get this message from, Hardboiled? I don't see anything new here on the Steam forum. Now it's 50%? Whoa! After I lost my 1K bet and my 2K bet. Oh. Wait. Did I help you out to get you started again? Oh, it's on the update? Oh wow, there's two more people that have written on here. Why doesn't it give me a comment? Like, why doesn't it say, hey, you should check this? There's new comments. Do I have to subscribe to it? No, it's not subscribed to RSS. Why am I not getting like messages? Oh, subscribe to thread? Do I have to manually click that every time? Anyways, I'll write these people back later. I think I already wrote these people last night. This was 20 hours ago. I wrote people last night at like 8 hours ago. So I think I already handled these, but I'll go and check and then comment later. Okay, to see whether these are dark. Oh. So it was my fault with the points. What is it with Steam with that? Rocket Bunny, what's up, man? It's supposed to subscribe you to every thread you comment on. Oh. No, Arcane, you don't have to do anything you don't want to, man. This is better. That's pretty good. This darkness level works really well. So now I'm going to make these also. Make these the light color. No, I don't know. I'm gonna work on these little pillars now, light pillars. That's pretty good. I like these. But maybe these should be a little different. But still, I want to get more of this done. So there's the two pillar. Oh, that thing has a way cooler light than I thought. Let's get this thing, so we don't need that background, but we need it for a second. It's this color here though. This dark color is too dark, but this two statue is just about right now. So all right, let's see what that looks like. Wait, the glow is a separate thing. Two pillar, what is it again? Two pillar zero, probably? Yeah, two pillar zero. Black Iron! What's up, Black Iron? Yo! Yeah. the stream freeze? Not for Hardboil. All right, great. Not for somebody. Why didn't that update? 2-0, 2 pillar 0. Oh, it's because it's 2 light pillar 0. And then also getting the glow. I think the glow is on. You're truly evil. What? Pedro has 666 points. Did you do that on purpose? Okay, now let's try and get. This would be area creation. If the glow, it's the glow for the light pillar tile. Glow key size. This is where is it setting? Create, oh, there it is. Create entity. So it's going to be P. No, this is going to be auto Z equals render component. Get Z order. Okay, Z mid. Offset. Zero. Offset. Pause. KZ mid, offset 0, pause, P. There we go. Set that Z. I think this Z should also be like plus. Oh, this is the offset 0.1F, I think. The door is looking much better. The big boss door, cool. Steve Tramby, what's up, man? Oh, there we go. That's the color I wanted to see for these lights. But there's still not enough light coming off of them. I think there is light coming from them though, like they are actual light components. Yeah, so if I stand over here. Okay, good. Okay, let's make this light a lot brighter. I'm actually going to use a regular brush. But with not so much opacity. 25% opacity, brush, delete tool. I'm a long time moral support whiz. That's my contribution. Yes, you are. Don't call him a traitor. What am I working on? I'm working on level 2 art right now. So, yeah, there's a lot of things in level 2 that just never got done as far as the artwork. I just kind of haphazardly tossed stuff together from level 1. And today I'm finally going back and saying, you know what? Enough's enough. I've got to do level 2. A regular brush, scandalous. I can't believe you're losing a regular brush. This is so... You're going to get impeached for this. The President of the United States himself. Let's see how that looks. Save. This is the two light pillar glow zero. Replace. Yes. Nice. Free parking. Do it all with pixels. No brushes. That would be really. That would have taken forever. Now they finally have the right light color. Thinking these might actually be the door color instead of the light color, though. Yeah, let's try them with the door color. Which is K color key? No, wait, what's the key color? K color... Not water. Plant? Maybe plant. Yeah, that's more of a complimentary color. And now they should at least glow a bit. Nims glow. Sprite. Valtry data. Oh, I don't want to do Valtry data. Just type K and you'll find everything. Yeah, I know, right, Steve? Oh, Steve Tramby, I should talk with you about this, actually. Today I was working with batch nodes. Actually, since last night, working on batch nodes and stuff like that to try and get the GL draw calls for the game to be a lot better. I'll show you what I mean. I have so many GL draw calls because every single sprite is a custom sprite. And... the auto batching doesn't work with if you've ever set a uniform, a custom uniform. So the auto batching basically still doesn't work. And so I tried a few things. I tried using batch nodes, and batch nodes didn't work out because batch nodes, they put everything at the same Z level. So you can see right here I have 500 GL draw calls. It really should be more like 50. And it gets worse in other levels. Like some levels, I'm all the way up to 1500 GL draw calls. So basically, I tried batching, but what happens with the batch node is it actually draws, I think what's happening is it draws all of your sprites in the same go. So you can't actually use global Z order. If you do use global Z order, you're only affecting the layer, the tiles within that layer or whatever. So basically, I threw everything into one batch node. I had to do two different batch nodes because I have a texture for the level, I have a texture for common things like the player and stuff. Manually batch. Just set the uniform in all sprites. Yeah. That's what I was thinking. So I tried actually making it so the uniform was in all sprites by doing, you know how there's CC underscore time, there's CC underscore random. I tried implementing my own version of those. Like, I tried to add all these things, and I was getting close. I was getting really close. I almost had it to run with no errors, but for some reason there was some error. So anyways, I'll try it out later, and I'll let you know what I find. But basically, I'm doing that. Instead of using batch nodes, I'm using CC, like a CC time, I'm doing CC underscore all the different uniforms that I use in my main shader for all the texturing for... So anyways, I'll let you know how that goes. Yeah, I did use set global Z order. Yep. I, Okay, yeah, I will. Yeah, yeah. All right, yeah. I'll let you know. I'll let everybody know on the stream too. What a fine. But basically, yeah. So if anybody's following that on the YouTube videos later on, I'm basically trying to use my own built-in Cocos 2DX uniforms so that I can use Cocos 2DX's regular batching or auto batch. Cocos 2DX's auto batching, which would greatly reduce the GL draw calls of this game. Okay, anyways, sprite run action. This is a repeat forever sequence. Cycle delete causes things to not batch. You may want to use the OpenGL Z coordinate instead. Really? Oh. Well, it did seem to be working though with batching. So when I was trying to last night, and I've already had the game engine using set global Z, and when I tried it last night, I did convert it over to batch nodes. I had everything in a batch node, and it did reduce the GL draw calls. So that's what I'm thinking was confirmation that it was actually batching. So I think that was working. But in the end, what I found out was that there's just the Z. When of all the tiles that got put in the batch node, there was no way to distinctify their Z versus another batch node Z. Yeah, batch node separate, yeah. So let's do it. Kit ease, K ease sign in. Fade to create over 1.618. Let's go halfway. Then back to full. Yeah, exactly why they're bad. Totally, yeah. They must have been necessary. You can do like a timeout render and create triangle command yourself. Oh! Oh, now that's interesting. Oh, cool. I'm glad we're rapping about this. Cause it's giving some ideas. Maybe one of these things will work, you know? I'm sure something will work and I can reduce the GL draw calls. Hey, that's a lot better. Seeing these things glow. I think I want them to not quite go down to 128 though, maybe like 168. We better not just spam the stream. All right, yeah. Cool. Yeah, maybe I'll do it on tomorrow's stream then if I haven't figured it out tonight. Okay, next thing, I want these pillars to look better. So you can see over here, they're really boring, plain looking pillars. I want them to look awesome. Merge these blurs, keep this one blur layer. Blur, glow. Okay, back to the regular pillar. I want to do some dark effects on the sides. Firewatch? No, I haven't played it. What does the data type this do, and what's the purpose of do loops. You always crash my game. Huh. You're talking about C, right? This is a pointer to the current object. And as far as do loops, they just loop over something until you tell them to stop. Their do loop is like a while loop, but you are specifying how long to loop for in the end of the do loop instead of the beginning of the while loop. As to why they always crash your game's code, I'm not sure without looking at your game code. Three hours well spent. All right. So I'm gonna get a little bit more Q. What could be done about the, oh, here we go. Let's get a nice highlight. Actually, maybe this whole thing should be highlighted. Maybe around the center. It kind of looks funny. You only paid $5? Whoa. Yeah. These little touches make all the difference. Let's see that one as a pillar and as a light tile. Let's call that 2Pillar 0 and 2Light Pillar 0. Yeah, shush on the story. Don't tell people. Boogie, what's up, man? Too pure, a little not dark enough on the edges. Maybe Maybe a little too dark on the edges, actually. Maybe that's the problem. Doop doop doop. That's good. Like that. Just like that. Yeah. Darken that up a bit. Yes. Darken it. See how that looks. Two pillar zero. Have fun in the ghost town. Why didn't it repack? Come on, repacker, repack it. By the power of Grayskull! What happened? Did I not set this out right? Looks like I didn't. Let's try that one more time. Come on. Export. Two pillar zero. Replace. Yes. Should be repacking. Looks like it is repacking. This is starting to look better. All right, let's do a couple more then. First of all, if this is a pillar, it looks like that, and this glow already has this glowy sprite thing, and this does not need to be like that. Let's get that up. Nice-ed up. Okay, and let's create a timeline so we can export all three of these at once. Well, once there are three. There we go. No more propagate one. Okay, so there's pillar zero. One and two. Okay, one's gonna be shorter. Two is going to be 1 pixel shorter. Start by making sure that that rendered everything okay. That's going to be frame one. This is going to be frame two. One, two, three. Render this. can explain Steam trading cards to me? Yes, please, somebody explain this to me too. I don't know what the hell Steam trading cards are. Alright, it's difficult to tell the difference between these. Let's give frame one so it has two of these. You can collect the entire set and then you win Steam levels, or you can sell them. But Steam only gives you half of the set from playing, but it can give you duplicates. Ah, so you trade them with other players to make a set, and then the set gives you a badge. I get it. So we basically, Steam trading cards are ways of winning badges. That's really all that you collect them, make sets, win badges, earn badges. Okay, this is looking good, but this highlight here needs to be less strong. Oh, and it's also how you gain useless Steam levels as well. Steam levels. So what are... Oh, the Steam level, like, okay, I'm level 4, I'm level 5 now on Steam. And when you craft a badge, you can usually win an emote from the game. Wallpaper on your profile. Better. All right, it's getting better and better moment by moment. Yeah, you gotta do it for that 10% of people, right? Steam levels only increase the chance of winning foil cards. Foil cards sell for more than in the market and can be used to craft badges too. Are they funny? Are your badges funny? Mm-hmm. Cold Hard Virtual Cash. So can you use virtual cash to like buy badges or buy Steam trading cards? You can have more friends in your friend list. Oh. Nice. Intern, programmer, manager, CEO. Nice, man. I like it. Oh, so you sell them for Steam Wallet money, which is like your virtual money, right? Yeah, store credit. You can also buy games with it, though. So you can sell your Steam card. So there's more than just earning badges. I can see why 10% of the people, which we're assuming, would love that. Would love that feature. And I'm sure that generates interest for Steam, and that's why they do it. All right, let's see those. Oh, you know, I want to see. Let's try that first. Sold all your cards. You got about $10 of pure spending money on the sale. Hey, right. How many cards was that you sold to make 10 bucks? Whoa, half of your games were bought from selling CSGO items? That's significant. Hello, Zilton. What's up? Welcome to the stream. I'm making some pixel art for level 2. Working on all the things that go into level 2, like the pillars, the statues, the doors. Eventually, I'll get to the doors. I haven't got to those yet. All right, yeah, that just needs to be a little thinner on top. Ooh. My sins have caught up with me from using the pencil or the brushy eraser. A lot, but I also had like two foils which sold for $1 or $2 each, huh? Wow. So they were worth a lot and you only got like 10 bucks? Looks okay, but the bottom looks weird. All these bottoms look weird. Weird bottoms. Re-render, see how that looks. So yeah, right now I'm working on these little pillars, and I'll be working on some more stuff. What do I work on next? Maybe the doors. Most cards worth about 8 cents. Dang. Do you have a current account value of that high? That's amazing. You can calculate the Steam value of your... let's see what mine is. How do I get to this? Steam... Oh, SteamDB.info calculator. Mine's gonna be worth like 8 cents, I'm telling you. Do, do, do. Get disappointed in your life. Zilton, yeah, I'm making this in Cocos 2DX. It's a game engine for C++. I'm making it with a C++, Cocos 2DX, on Xcode, mostly on a Mac, but I also develop on Windows in Visual Studio, and also on Linux. I develop with CMake and, you know, all the other stuff on Linux. So this is a cross-platform game, and it'll also be on iOS and perhaps some other platforms that will be announced later on. We'll see. Whoa, look at this. My account value has $200. That's ridiculous. It's way too high. I'm already Steam level 9. That's also seems high. Wow. Well, that was fun. I have 900 experience points. Whoa. That was fun. $2 more than Miss? Really? That's, we had almost exactly the same value? 205? Whoa. That's funny. Azarus, 700 pounds? I know, right? Yeah, 29% of my games are not even played. Because I constantly am developing. I don't have time for playing all these games. But I do have time to play the awesome ones like Axiom Verge. Okay, so what should I do with these pillars? So these, should I change anything more? I guess I didn't even look at the bottoms. I just changed. That should update those bottom ones there. Yeah, this is okay. This is good enough for now. I'd like to get on to moving on, work on the doors, and also the beginning part here. This little strip of land or carpet or whatever this is. Okay, this one's good enough for now. Also, I want to copy though this light pillar 0. Okay. Next, let's do that black piece of ground. I think that's going to be two entrance. I want this thing to be curvy. There it is, dais. All right, select that layer. Move its selection over here. Invert that. Oh, wait. Convert that again. No. There. $610 with 46 not played. And none of them are Isaac. I know, I gotta get Isaac. I gotta get Isaac. Oh, Hardboiled. Hardboiled, I wanna ask you, should I play Isaac on Mac or should I play it on Windows? Cause I know it's the old one had a lot of issues, and but it might have been just because I was playing it on Mac. So maybe I should just play it on Windows. I don't know. Oh no, this link doesn't work. What's this a picture you sent, Azarus? Oh, it's just a world map for Link's Awakening? That's cool, man. I did that a while ago when I was working on like the, you know, procedural generation of the Wolververse. I looked at the original Legend of Zelda's map all the time. Kept looking at it and looking at it and looking at it. Fascinated with it. I still am. I still think the original Legend of Zelda map is so cool. Also, I'm really inspired by Mystic Quest. Dude, they got a sweet map. Link's Awakening, of course, is a great map. Does it open for me? What's up? Come on, internet. Oh, there it goes. Yeah. Totally. That bottom left sand, the top left, like, foresty thing. I forgot all about this watery area. This whole background was gone. Or layer via cutted. Oops. $1,700. Nice, Steve Trammy. 86% unplayed, right? It's the sales. That's crazy. We all have such high not played rates. Oh, you know what? It needed that layer. That layer was part of its magic. I just need to set it to be invisible. This layer is 100% transparent. Damn it, I just did that again. Come on, render it, render it, render it. Yeah, render it. My future self has eyes larger than its appetite. Spending money on games is apparently more fun than playing them. Will Songbringer be able to out a bitmap of your generated world? Yes, yes it will, Azenris. I do have plans for that. It's already got the ability to do that with what am I trying to say? It's already got that overworld scene thing I do sometimes. Let me show you. Basically, this is not going to be very hard to do because I already got the ending credit sequence is half of the equation, and this overworld scene thing is the other half of the equation. Really, it would take only like an hour or two to get it so it would actually generate a bitmap of the entire world. So this, you know, this is World Tuxedo right here. 15 dead ends, 26 secrets, 9 interest points. It took 8 retries for it to generate that world because it must have, you know, it generated one. It failed to check, you know, for some reason the world just failed, like, maybe there was one area that couldn't be, you couldn't get to like level 1 or something. So yeah, I'm going to combine this with the code at the very end of the game. It runs the credit sequence and it shows a bunch of different areas. All I got to do is do that for every single area, take a screenshot, put it all together, stitch it all together and make a PDF map and boom. So there will be PDF maps, bitmaps, but it will be, I'm not sure if it will be released. Or what? I'm not sure how to release that. I probably will kind of keep it secret at first and only release some bitmaps of a few worlds. But we'll see. No way. Hardwell got deleted again? Come on! Dang, somebody's going ban happy here. Arcane's got an angel and a devil on his shoulders. Number one town, make a guide for more money. You mean in the game, like how to get more diamonds? Yeah, get a snack. Get a snack for me too, man. I'm hungry. Okay, so this needs more. It needs like some ground texture that looks right. That doesn't look right at all. But I think if I ride the elevator up, it might look okay. Up here. Oh no, it didn't. Oh yeah, it does look okay right here. Sort of. It does need some kind of ground texture. It's just probably that this one was too dark. Let me set a lighter color for that. If only I knew the truth. Nice try, Steve. Try lighting that up. Oh yeah. Oh, so Zilton, you gotta click follow to get the The points working. Oh, you did it. Right. Nice. You got 5 points already. Oop, that turned out too light. Yeah, too light. Okay, let's do a custom brightness contrast layer. Let's try 50 instead of 100. Well, Steve Drammy immediately jumps to the front of the leaderboard with his 990,000 bajillion points. A sarcastic high five emote. Why isn't there? Oh, that's looking better. Sort of. There's still something wrong with it. I'm gonna try roughing up the bottom. I don't know if this style is going to look right. We'll see. Pretty sure it's possible. Can we buy Steam keys with points? Yes, you can. You can't buy them, but you can raffle them. You can win them. Yeah, that looks really stupid. Bam. Undo, undo. Isn't Harbaugh such a nice guy? What to do about this one? This like this a while ago, but maybe this will work. If I go 12 pixels tall, Wait, can I ask you, what is the thing you're working on? Because I can't unsee it as a pillar. Right? I'm working on this bottom. It's supposed to be like a... It's supposed to be like almost like an entry carpet. Maybe I should use the other one from one. Let's try the other one. One has this one entrance. It looks like this. It's path. Wow, that's really bright. Let's see if it's even anywhere near the right brightness first. Two more pixels up, and that's way too bright. How did that get so bright? Oh, because it's underneath this brightness contrast. Wait. Yeah, now it's starting to look more right. Still not the right color. But what if it was darker? And then I'll make the lines look cooler. It's a give point party. The black garbage can in the center. Yep. Now it's just too dark. It should be way darker, actually. Yeah, my next major task is beta. I gotta get to the beta. The beta is gonna be this Sunday, so there's a lot of work left to do to get that. And I kind of want to handle all these little basic things that I don't know that have to do with getting the foundation of the game right, and then it'll be bosses, levels. items. There's still, oh, it's like there's still some item work left to do. Yeah, I know. Boss streams. Yeah, I got to get to boss streams, right? Oh, we do number four before number three. What happened to this? Why didn't it run? Run. No, it's not an actual rule of game design. Oh, there we go. Now it's starting to look more right. Within that context. But it still needs, like, to be... I don't know. It needs some strips applied to the... Well, wait, first let's make that... Not 150, but, like... 100? And then on this thing... I'm going to do another layer on top of it. It's totally black. No, actually, I'll make it this color. There we go. Now just fade that a bit. Now let's see how that looks. I'm definitely not on number four yet. Do it on Thursday, Friday when I can watch. All right, cool. Thursday or Friday, so coming up sometime soon, will be a boss stream. Needs to be a tiny bit darker. Yeah, Zilton, don't sweat it, man. It's, yeah, you'll get, learning game development takes time, but it's a really fun process. I'm sure you'll enjoy it, and Frozen Fire is creating an isometric game all about configuring the camera angle and drawing isometric art, or is there more to it than over a 2D side-scroller, for instance? Yeah, Frozen Fire, there's a lot more to it than just like a 2D side-scroller, for sure. For one thing, the actual, actually just drawing pixels in an isometric perspective is one of the most difficult art tasks there is, Frozen Fire. So you really gotta practice. If you're gonna do isometric, this is not isometric, by the way. This is called either orthographic or a three-quarters view. So this is a little bit easier. Side scroller is the easiest art of all. But if you're asking if there really is more to it than just, yeah, there is, man. There really is a lot more to it because you really got to change the way your code works and everything. So good. Now this entrance is a tiny bit too dark. Actually, that one's not dark enough. Let's make that a little darker. Yeah, Steve Trammy's isometric is more difficult to deal with in many ways. Draw ordering, coordinate transform, off-axis movement. Yes, yeah, it is. But it's more rewarding, like he says. It looks quite a bit cooler. Cool, man. If you don't like Game Maker, then at least you know what you want. That's great. Start with, what do you want to start with then? Start with something. Get started making games. What are you probably already started. What are you using already? What's up? I got flux on, don't I? I can't see. Ah, that's better. Much better, man. Why isn't this working? I'm setting brightness way high and it's not affecting this layer. I'm so confused. Maybe because it's black. Let's try this one. It doesn't work either. Oh, yeah, it does. That's a brightness of 71. I'm gonna try 50 at first, though. It's maybe 60, 61. So the dais ground doesn't work. Confusing. So confusing. Mutant Ninja Turtle edition. Yes, isometric definitely is much more difficult than orthographic. Yeah. It is totally Mandel. It's totally, yes. Oh, I see the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle reference now. Yeah. This is so Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles right here. See if I manually adjust the brightness. Nothing. I'm getting no love. Why is this not getting brighter? Nothing changes. Oh, there. It worked if I did 150. Oh. This must be that dark. Okay, let's get that other bit. The only thing I really found lacking in Unity is 2D shadows. But you got it working? Cool. There is, yes, Deep Jam, you haven't seen it? Oh, let me show you. Okay, let me save this point that I'm at. There's a freaking Ninja Turtle on here. He totally was. Your idea was totally different, but I messed it up. I was supposed to draw a little turtle floating around, but I actually drew a ninja turtle. So yeah, there's a few characters aboard the ship. These will eventually be NPCs. You'll be able to talk to them and stuff. And there'll be a tons more. And your NPC will be here, Steve Tranby. Everybody, Steve Tranby backed the game at one of the awesome backer levels that allowed him to design his own NPC. So he's gonna have his own NPC in the game. And a couple other people got it too. That was all the way back at the Kickstarter in May. Thank you again. Thank you again. This game is made possible by Steve Tramby and 800 other people. Thank you, backers. Forever. Lith, what's up, Lith? That's the ship. He's no ninja. Your NPC better be 10 times the size? No problem, man. As big as you want. You want a really, really big guy? No problem. Done. Agreed. Yeah, this is already starting to look a lot better. This entrance. Doesn't quite go up here though. The lip is a bit too red. And this path thing is just a little bit too light actually. So this was a brightness of 150. Let's do hue, saturation, lightness. Whoa, that works too good. Alright, this layer here, where is this layer? Oh, there it is. Yeah, so this brightness needs to go even darker. What I make the soundtrack in? I make my soundtracks in Ableton. I use Ableton Live for making music. Wizard, how do you handle saving each level screen area? I don't save them. I do not save any areas in this game. It's all generated in memory. Still, wow, that's still too red. Too red, this little lip edge thing. Yeah, but now this is looking okay. Maybe. Cubase, yeah, Hartwell uses Cubase. How do you load each screen? Well, that's a big question. How do I load each screen? What part of it are you talking about? I mean, there's a lot to loading. Are you talking about the generating of tiles? Are you talking about the generating of sprites that go to represent the tiles? Are you talking about characters? What are you talking about? Deus lip top. So if we decrease the lightness that much, let's decrease the saturation a lot. How do you load each tile? So the game generates all of its tiles from the start with your world seed. So you have your six-letter world seed. That six-letter world seed is interpreted into a extra long, like a super-duper long integer value. That integer value is used to seed the random number generator, which is deterministic, so that on every platform that you play this game on, it will always generate the same world. Once it's got your random numbers seeded, then every single tile in the whole game is generated via a tile generation algorithm that, you know, says, okay, is this, what kind of area is this? And it generates all the tiles, right? And then, so for this area right here, it generated some, this kind of round shape for the bottom and top of everything. And then for each tile, there's nothing to do for loading it or whatever. It's already in memory. So really all it does is it just creates a sprite. So for example, this tile I'm standing on right here, it just created a single sprite. And that's it. I explained that right. Buying off your next band. Oh yeah, now that lip was a little less saturated, but still it's too brown. Needs less saturation. Yeah, for worlds randomly generated, but for a static world, I've heard it's just JSON files. You can do, no, there's lots of ways you can do that. If you want to do a static world and you don't want to go create your own whole system, you can use what's called, there's lots of different kind of tile, there's map editors basically. Check it out, there's tiled map editor. You might want to use this. It's called Tiled. There, it's called, it's mapeditor.org. Let me post a link for you. But this will store your stuff not as JSON, but actually as XML. So it's actually pretty easy to hand edit your files if you want. But you can also use this tiled map editor thing to do, you know, to lay out all your tiles and then load them. And that will create sprites for every one of your tiles. Twitch. Chat. Oh, there's Steve Tramieri, but thanks, Steve. Is there a benefit to creating a randomly generated level or a designed level? Yes, there are definite benefits to both. Zilton, that's a design question from your, you should ask yourself at the very beginning, before you even start making your game, what do you want? Do you want to, it's called bespoke. A bespoke world is one where every level, everything is handcrafted. Most games are that way. A lot of games today are actually going procedurally generated, but it depends on how good they do their procedural generation. So it also depends on how good of a programmer you are. So that's part of your design decision should be, all right, am I good enough at programming to pull off a procedurally generated world that's cool? Because it is a lot of programming work. So, you know, it's also a design decision from the gameplay standpoint. What do you think is more fun for you as a player? What would you rather play? Would you rather play a bespoke world where everything was hand-designed and handcrafted? Or would you rather play something that's totally different every time, like Diablo, you know? Red Carpet Rampage? Hardball, I'm going to, I promise. Leo's Red Carpet Rampage, and it works in my Twitch browser. I'm Leonardo DiCaprio. That's actually kind of fun. Oh, that's so funny. So funny. That's a good game. Who made that? You don't really care? God damn, why is this though still brown colored? Wait, maybe. Oh, maybe the whole time. Yeah, that's probably what it was. The whole time I didn't update that over there. Right? This has got to be it. The Revenant. I haven't seen The Revenant, but I heard some people were going this weekend, some of our friends. Oh, there we go. Now it's starting to look, but it's now it's just not saturated enough. All these little tweaks. This is what art is. It's just lots and lots and lots and lots of tweaking stuff like this. That's why it's best to make up your mind fast as possible with art. Because you could spend all, I could spend all day just tweaking the colors for this art to try and make it even more perfect. LimeWire, yeah. Yeah, LimeWire is old school. That was like Napster-y days, right? Wasn't it Napster back then? See, now it's too dark. Did someone say lime? Yep. We were saying lime like three times. Lime. 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 Lana. 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 What? What? Now the other ones are broken. Darker now? It does. A little darker. Any chance there will be multi-level dungeons? Okay, that's something I've been thinking about lately. I think there might actually be one multi-level dungeon in this game. I think the last level might be multi-level. I'm not sure though. It's a good thought though. I've been thinking about that a lot. Why does this all of a sudden go super wonky looking? Yeah, upstairs, downstairs. You basically would have levels of Z inside a level. He's got sewers. Yeah, right. Oh, I feel like been tweaking this way too long. It just like doesn't get any better. Let's go. Alright, I need to take a break from this section and work on something else. Let's go back to the overworld and the entrance for all this. And let's make it daytime. Skip ahead in time, probably with 300. Yeah, all right, so these statues look horrible. Gotta work on these. That's gonna be the O2 statue. Which I just wanna cover with some grass. We've got O2 statue 0 through 1. Let's get rid of those. I know the squirrel's been stuck for months. Yay, it finally doesn't look like a turtle. Woo! I know, right? How long have I been saying, like, yeah, I should work on that turtle, or I mean that squirrel, and I never do it. All right, these are gonna need to be lightened up. And put some grass on them and make them look more crumbly, like they're just about to fall apart because they're outside. Or I could take the color of the entrance. Yeah, I should apply the color of the entrance. About that. What's happening with the statue shadow? It's because Jib now has a light. He's casting a shadow. I need to work on the shadows and make it so Jib's light doesn't cast as much of a shadow. So watch if I move Jib around. It's all from his light. So I guess gotta work on it and make it so his shadows don't cast that much shadowiness. What color are these things supposed to be? Create statue tile. It's just renders from its statue element, which is gonna be two statue. That's gonna be an entities. There we go. Yeah, so 0, 2, statue, number, fallback, color type rock. These are always going to be color type rock. Well, let's see what happens when we make them the right color. He's a squirrel, not a cat. Eight sacrificial lambs. See you, Lime. Later, man. Yeah, later. All right, so what if this statue was roughly the same color? Saint, what's up? Saint Nath. Didn't work. Why didn't that work? 0 to statue 0. That's the right color. I just didn't pack it. What? There, now packed. They're still not colored right. Maybe it's because the rock color is that color. So what if I took off raw, the color type? Yeah, color type needs to be applied. So maybe, I guess I will keep this, but let's just add some green. You're still rooting for the squirrel? I just want to see him get out of there. There, hopefully this looks a little better with some grass on it. Yeah, make it Mozzie, right? Make it Mozzie. More Mozzie, man. It's not Mozzie enough. Mozzie it up. Mozzie it down, too. Mozzie it around. Wax it on, wax it off. Wax all that moss. Make it waxy. Make it really bright and shiny. Yeah, kind of, right? Wondering if it should be darker or lighter overall. I'm gonna try a little darker. Is he tripping? Yeah, he's totally tripping. Squirrel found some stuff to trip on. No, if I get behind him, he should. Why? Yeah, why? I think he's stuck. I think he's totally stuck. What if I come in from the other? Let's see. Let's fix the squirrel real quick, huh? That's something I've been saying I would do, and I never did. So let's do it now. Yeah, I think he's totally stuck. Yeah, he can't even move. Probably because he's being placed wrong. Squirrel. There's something that gives the each. Man, I don't even know what function it's going to be using. Let's find out. So when he creates a squirrel, let's set a breakpoint. He's not allowed to walk on the grass. Oh, you can barely even see the moss, yeah. All right, so it creates the being. It's alive. It takes its original position and we gave it. Oh, it just skipped over everything, didn't it? Oh, I guess all it needs to do then is do move system. He's the end boss as a squirrel? That would be hilarious. Squirrel really worth the time now? Yeah, he's totally worth it. He's totally worth it. Move system, set any valid position. Auto id equals create AI id mask. I'm not sure. I think it's just when you put zero there, allow edges. You just walk over him and he dies. It's like Mario, but way easier. You jump on people's heads. But now he's gone. Where'd he go? They can scare him into motion if I run around. Now he's like totally gone. Where'd you go, squirrel? Where you at? He's gone. He's dead. What happened to the squirrel? As soon as you try and set him in the right point, he's just like, gives up on life. That's it. I can't take it anymore. Pause, X, Y. We got 210. 84. It's like about where I set him in the first place. So say to any valid position, I must be doing this wrong. Set any valid. Oh, you gotta take its move mask, that's right. Roll the credits, that's it. Step on the squirrel. Yeah, there he is. Oh, he's running, actually. Yay, he can move finally. You're free now, squirrel. Run around as much as you want. Don't worry, I won't fight you, I promise. Yay. At least he moves. Okay, so you're right, the moss was a bit, I think it needs to be a little bit brighter. I don't know, let me check overall. Overall, this thing might need to be a little darker. Yay for the squirrel! Won't someone please stop the itching? You like the moss how it is? Cool. Let's see what it's like though with if the whole pillar were a little darker. And then I'm gonna try a little lighter maybe. We all did it! Yay! I think that does look a little bit better. To another level. Level 2. Alright, so this is what this level is like. I gotta use some map drones. I'm not gonna show my quantity there. Found a bug. Drake. What will the wild squirrel do next? Oh, Jib should scan him, huh? Scan the squirrel? So what, that just didn't really reveal anything there? Check for rabies, though. I know so many code tasks, but I've gotten a lot of them really fixed. What am I down to now? So I'm down to 42 cards on my code list. That's really, really low compared to what it was. I started off at 80 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago or whatever. Okay, I get it. It's not revealing what's... I don't know, should it? You guys think that the scanner drones should show me where a potential level is with an X? Or should they just show the paths like this? I think for now I'll probably leave it how it is. I still would like to see some other levels. Oh, here's one. This is actually a good one. This one's colored differently. This is 1170. 117. Wait, 510. Yeah, 1170 is a good one to check. All right, let's do this one. Stone, they should be the same color as the blocks over there. Which would be a matter of taking off this. Does Bafu explode if you bet 4K? Ah, that's better. Much better. Yeah. Now the right hue. What if the base that she's standing on is the same color as the stone? There we go. And now let's make it a copy of this. And we'll make this the right color. So its top should be about that color. Its highlight colors like that. That's wrong. What's wrong with that? Guys, you guys are your. All right, just to get a sense of how this might look with a gray color, I'm doing this, and I'm gonna make it, make this grass look better too. Help cure. Yeah, what's that cure command? Ooh, where did I put this? Common? No. Must be level. Oh yeah, O2 entrance. Oh, I didn't apply any darkness from the level color to it. So if anything, it just needs to be a little darker. Free parking. I just won it. Whoa. Yeah, that's right. Suck it, everybody. I won 154 points. That's right. I'm gonna gloat over this victory forever. Everyone shall remember this day. It's the day that I won 154 points, and you didn't. Ha. Yeah, Boogie's the one that actually wrote it. He's the one that worked the hardest. Whoa, that turned out weird. The grass is really weird colored. And just that one little change did all that? That's good, Zilton. Do it out of order. Oh, then you won the points today. Oh. Wow, look at that. That one little difference made all the difference. You should write that down. Somebody should write that down. That one little difference made all the difference. It's all you need to know in life. There you go. Random quote. Yeah, I think I like it more colored like the stone. It's getting really weird in how it displays. I know there was. There's been some funny ones. Oh, see, now I just went over that threshold. Now that color is too dark. Oh, it's the color burn. That's what's doing that. All right, maybe I'll draw 50% opaque here. Whoops. Hold on. We need to store this color and this color and not that color. Not that color. Ah. All right, if that looks right, then I'll finish the grass. And this image will be done for now. Oh, let's get rid of these. Oops, forgot to turn on the darkness. See, here goes an hour just working on this one little thing. But hell, it's already looking a lot better than it used to. Now, hopefully the whole thing can go a little darker without crossing that threshold. Honks. We're already at 220. Yep, gotta get going soon. But I do want to finish this one little thing here. This bottom platform. Oh, damn it. Cross that threshold. Okay, I'm just gonna go back it up until I can see both colors about right and call it good for now. This is taking too long. Oh, it's the shadow. All right, and the lighter color for the grass. Yeah, that looks horrible. Oh man, this is really tough doing these. Trying to make these rock colors match without actually applying a color type. These should be two separate things. So this will be the two entrance. And if I make an entity, where's the entrance at? One, entrance, two, entrance, two, entrance. If I get two children, one child is let's call this the rock part. Okay, so this part of the entrance is its own thing. And then this part of the entrance is its own thing. This will be O2 entrance rock. And start compiling that. Rock is going to be position -9. Name entrance rock. Doesn't even need a name, really. To entrance rock. Z order is going to be mid. Color type rock. Hope that works. Pedro. All right, see you, man. Good night. All right, now if it worked, that'd be nice. Come on, work with me. Two entrance rock, maybe just didn't get. Oh, it's supposed to be O2 entrance. Oh. Wait, what's the difference between two entrance and O2 entrance? Oh, of course. Well, where's O2 entrance at? There's no. Maybe there's zero at? Oh, now I'm confused. Unless it's just. Area, well, is this function called create entrance tile? Oh, it's not an entrance tile. It's actually in stairs. This is a stairs tile, no wonder. Stairs tile. Man, this is some old school code right here. This needs to really be updated to the new data-driven situation. So if it has this rock key, create an entity real quick. All needs is a position and a render. And then set its color type. I could say set its color, which would be this get color. Okay, color rock. All right, hopefully that works. Yes. Oh, finally we have the right colors. It's off by a pixel though. Alright, so yeah, this is about it for today's stream, guys. This is looking better. This is looking better than it did before, that's for sure. The problem now is that it looks too smooth, right? I applied all that. I was trying to do all that messing with these colors for this little rock entity here in the middle, and it wasn't working because it was applying a different color type. So now that it's got the right color type, after dinner tonight, I can come back in here and make sure this contrast is looking good. Right now, there's not enough contrast in this. So, I'll work on that tonight. So, yup. You're tired, ended already? All right, man. Yep. So, yeah, have a good night, you guys. Enjoy yourselves, sleep well. I'm gonna get some dinner. We'll see you next time.